Looking like we're on air. At least that's what it said. Camera, we're there. We're looking good. Little face circle there. Suplex City shirt. Stream looks like it's good and going. So, I welcome you all in, everybody. It's the live stream Let's Play of MLB The Show 2016. Following the career of starting pitcher, one Derek Metzger, as we, pardon me, we're in the World Series. With the New York Yankees, we have, the good news is, we have the 2-1 series lead over the Pittsburgh Pirates. Whence we last left you, I lost that first game of the series, 2-0. It was a two-run shot. Pretty sure it was Francisco Cervelli, fucking Frankie, hit an outside slider, which I believe was on perfect timing, just mashed the ball to straight dead center field, and Jake Arrieta killed our batters. Killed them. Now, along the way, we had the same amount of strikeouts, I think 13 apiece, which is tremendous pitching. The good news is, even after that loss, we win Game 2 when Severino started on a 4-2 score. Then we won Eovaldi's game 3-1. Now, we will be in Pittsburgh for this game, which is the interesting news. What are you doing here? Close that shit up. And get that stuff away. Sorry. And I burped. Excuse me. When I look at the calendar. Okay, let's just say I win this game. Then there's a win, there's a win. We could be going for the sweep right now had I was able to get us the win in game one. But, thinking about it, okay, I played a game. Then there's 1, 2, 3 days in between my next start. Well, if this is game 4, 1, 2, 3 days in between, I potentially would start game 7 if that were the case, you know, if it's needed. So, that could be something to look to. Otherwise, this is going to be in Pittsburgh, and I need to take swings today. I'll be batting. We're looking to get a 3-1 series lead, or the series gets tied right here, 2 games apiece. So, play the next appearance. Let's get this rolling. A 100-win, 62-loss season. Pittsburgh is the wild card. CJ Stanford, I mean, look at him. 10 innings with damn near a 7 ERA. Whoa. I like our chances just based on how bad he's looking. Swig of organic green tea for the gamer guys and girls out there. That was more than a swig. That was much needed. Finished up a workout. Did some cardio. Oh boy, the fall classic. Here we go.
I tell you, this crowd is making it so I can hardly hear my own voice. They are indeed raring to go. It's game 4 of the World Series between the New York Yankees and the Pittsburgh Pirates.
Game 4.
Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to the World Series here on the show. With me are Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, lots of storylines here as we approach the start of Game 4.
And you can see the results right there. It's been about what we'd expected up to this point. Very tightly played, very tightly contested series so far. It sits at 2-1 right now, but I've got a feeling it's going to take at least 6 games, maybe even all 7 games, to decide a winner in this one.
It'll be interesting.
The postseason is officially in full swing. Lineups and first pitch coming up next.
I like it. But see, we're the road team. We're going to miss the top half of the first because this game just simulates through it automatically.
Back now as we draw ever closer to first pitch, let's listen in to public address announcer Mike Carlucci.
We're going to miss the top half of the first.
And now,
I don't like how it does that. That's the Pirates, all right. Well, unless we can work to the bottom half of the order.
And briefly here, a glance at the two starters who'll get the ball here in this one.
Look at that, 11.3 strikeouts per 9.
So now let's take a look at Joe Girardi's lineup for the visiting Yankees. What's this lineup got to do tonight to get a W on the road, Steve?
Jesus.
Well, I'll tell you what. This team has their ace on the mound, so it's probably not going to take a whole lot of offense to
Bowler
get a win.
And Mariznick, the only good batting average is worth a damn. Trumbo, not bad for the World Series.
CJ Stanford is the man on the mound for the fourth game of the series. What do we need to know here, EK?
Well, remember, guys, he's a young pitcher, still garnering a lot of experience, and he has a lot of upside. If he continues to improve, he's going to be around this league for a very long
time.
Okay,
so he's a lefty.
I can't wait to watch him in this one.
With a moment now, let's give you a look at how the Pirates align defensively. It's brought to us
no
by
gold
Majestic.
Gloves out there.
Eric, what do we need to know?
Well, Matty, Gregory Polanco has three traits that make him an incredible outfielder.
And I'll bet you the first half is going. Yeah,
speed.
I can always see gray jerseys out there.
He's got an
so what happened in the top of the first?
Getting ready now is Starling
Marte. We have a 3-0 lead. No big deal.
Half of inning number one.
Okay.
Starling Marte.
I said watch it, but okay.
Here's the first pitch slider that just tails out of the zone. It's ball one.
Come on, Marte. Well, we have a 3-0 lead starting the game. The fact that I didn't see it.
1-0
pitch. Kind of irritates
me. Swung on and missed 1-1.
Yeah, you've got a cold night. The ball won't be carrying as well. So you can afford to take a few more chances in the strike zone and challenge some guys. In that case, up in the strike zone.
Thought that was in there.
No
come on,
offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Yeah, right back to that inside location. When a guy shows you he can't handle a tough slider on the hands, you can bet that guy on the mound, he's going to go right back to that pitch before
good,
too long.
Good, good.
Nip the corner, 2-2. One of the things that makes him so tough to hit, the ability to put his pitches right on the black.
Yeah, I mean, you watch the catcher's glove on some of these, and it literally does not move. That's how good his stuff is.
Here's a high pop-up.
That's you. I'll run away.
Making the play
one
over
down,
there is Abreu for the first out.
I would hate getting speedy guys, leadoff fuckers on base. So
maybe a fastball middle in. You know, instead, they drop a curveball on him, and it really threw him off stride.
I don't have a fastball for him to worry about. It's just movement, movement, movement. That's all I do.
Here's Gregory Polanco.
Mm.
As he'll go after the first pitch here and pop one up over toward the left side of the infield. And Headley will look
one
this
pitch
one in
out,
for
good.
Round number two.
I can deal with this.
Whatever he's doing out there, it's working out for him. That's back-to-back pop-ups here to start the inning, and he's just making it look easy.
Francisco Cervelli gets his first cuts now. The bases are empty, and there are two away here in the opening frame.
Fucking Frankie.
Yeah, nothing doing so far here. He kind of needs to put up a tough at-bat right here just to make this guy work a little bit.
Screwball.
I tried keeping that
too
one up.
Low, 1-0. And set up behind
Clyde.
The dish is Clyde
C-Dub.
Washington, as you see the rest of our umpiring crew there.
Yeah, man.
I don't remember
Clyde
what
has
he's
a
like.
Bit of a reputation for rewarding pitchers that pound the bottom of the zone. Calls the game well, but we might see some strike calls
slapper
below the zone
to
that
short.
Hitters aren't going to be too happy with.
Throw
good.
On to first, gets him,
out
and
of the
side
inning.
Is retired.
Watch game.
1-2-3 go the Pirates. They trail it here 3-0.
Three hits, three runs. And I'll get some swings here soon enough. Well, we got a three-run lead. That's not ideal.
Chase
you know,
Headley will get his first opportunity here. And if you go by the numbers, it's been a disappointing start to this World Series for him so far.
Yeah, he really hasn't gotten on track. And I think you have to give some of that credit to good pitching. But he's really been a bit of a non-factor so far. Still time for him to turn it around, though.
He's not that good of a batter. He's just not. 29 pitches, we worked him. What, Headley, Ahmed, and Metzger, so I'll be third up.
And a check swing here, but he clearly went around on a pitch that would have been a
chopping.
Strike anyway. It's nothing in one. Chop foul right at home plate.
Oh, boy. Work the count a little bit here, come on. He's already at 30. I mean, fuck, let's
into
run that number up.
Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings
fucking
and misses for the first out of the inning.
If you want to see a guy get blown away at the plate, this is just one finger down three times in a row. He's just overmatched there.
When you can't get three fastballs in a row, oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, nice. Oh, I'm in the... Okay, I'm on the batter's box now.
Nick
Ahmed.
As he'll take a changeup here for strike one.
Well, that's unique.
You kind of wonder if he's learned anything out there. There's another pitch right down the middle. I think he's lucky that one didn't get hit a long way.
And I got to go power swings, because I'll probably be the third out coming up, you know what I mean? Go yard, I say.
Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
Yeah, kind of a late decision to swing there.
You're about 16 years late for your Millennium New Year's party there.
Right.
Jesus Christ, was that swing just not there?
Change up, and he ain't buying it. One and two.
Hey, he took a pitch
right there that you got to lay off. You know he's going to throw it on an 0-2. And
I mean, what, did we get lucky in the top half
of
the first?
Right there.
This guy looks like he's owning us now.
Here's the 1-2 delivery. Fought off at the plate, and we'll do it again.
It's right there. Yeah, get the ball, kid. Come on. Yeah,
bases
run the pitch count up a little bit, guys. I don't have discipline. I'm a fucking pitcher. I'm gonna get up there and swing the first thing that's low.
Ball, so two balls and two strikes now.
All right, 2-2. Not bad. This will be pitch 38 regardless. But I want to get him to 40.
Three and two now.
Okay.
We saw this in his last start. He just hasn't been able to find that put-away pitch with two strikes.
Fucking get a walk here. Walk his ass. Come on, pitcher. CJ, what's his nuts?
Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. And this one misses here. A close pitch on 3-2, but Clyde Washington rules it.
Here we go, everybody. I will be batting my first World Series at bat with a runner on.
Derek Metzger.
I don't know. Power
in a sacrifice situation. So let's see if that is indeed on right here.
Four seamer. The changeup's either going to drop or break back because he's a lefty. Slider's coming in. Running fastball is probably breaking away. I'll bet you the runner and the changeup have the same movement. I want to look down here.
Hit high in the air down the right field line. Polanco has a beat on it. He's got it, and there are two down now.
Well, that wasn't eventful.
Well, the only good news that comes out of this at-bat is that he stayed out of the double play. Other than that, this at-bat really didn't achieve a whole lot.
It was down.
Dexter Fowler will stand in.
Was not good, though.
He singled to lead off the ball game and later
told you, I got no discipline.
Score the game's first run.
And that really sparked
pitches.
That first inning rally. When you get your leadoff guys on like that, it can create a lot of excitement for everybody else that's got a bat in their hand.
Started to go around there, but he holds up ball one. That pitch count, as you see, already standing at 41.
Good.
And you don't need Eric or I to tell you about that. That's way too many this early.
3-0 at 41 pitches. That's even worse.
1-0 pitch. Swing and he pops him up over
That's
toward
flying
foul
out,
territory.
Flying out, flying out, flying out.
And nope, this one falls, so he'll get another shot.
Make him waste his arm a little more. Unlike me. Throwing the first fucking pitch.
No, high and wide. Two balls and a strike.
And I think that's been a big part of the problem so far. He just can't locate his fastball, especially in situations where he has to.
Two out with the man at first.
Batting will be an issue when you have no batting ability. So I don't expect myself to do much at the plate.
Change up, call to strike, and he comes back even at 2-2.
He'll throw 45 pitches here in two innings. Jesus Christ. 20 plus per inning. That'd be great if we could keep that going all day.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. Did a good job to
followed
shorten up
again.
And protect
right.
the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here.
All right.
Now a snap move over to first. Runner back safely.
So what the fuck was going on? Like, were they giving him the intentional or?
Strike three called as he can't get the bat off his shoulder.
Okay.
Side retired.
Still got the lead.
One left for the Yankees. But they're on top by a count of 3-0.
So, first at bat in the World Series, I took the first pitch for a slight ride down the opposite field line. What can I say?
John Jaso strides into the box now to lead off the home half of the second inning.
Boy, if it was Strasburg, I'd hit a two-run homer, right?
Into the windup and the pitch. And that's inside for a ball, 1-0.
Well, you got to figure that this guy's going to come out here free and easy here in the second. He's got a three-run cushion already. No reason not to come right after these guys.
Oh, I will.
Come on. Won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
This is a guy whose numbers are on the rise, and this is a big reason why. Two close pitches, two good takes, and now he's in a great hitter's count, 2-0.
3-0.
Jesus fucking Christ.
That questionable call on the previous pitch, it really changes the at-bat because he doesn't want to just lay one in there on 2-0.
Now I should just hit this
3-0
guy.
3-0, and the tide is not working in his favor.
Ready with the 3-0 pitch. Ripped on the ground to
good,
first.
Get him out.
Taken in by Abreu, and he'll take this to the bag. 3 unassisted for the first out.
That's got to feel like shit. You got 3-0. Then you dribble one of the first baseman.
We'll dig in now, and he's picked the wrong time of year for his bat.
Almost worse than
silent.
My at bat, except well, at least he worked the count a little bit.
Yeah, just one hit in the series so far for him, and they're gonna have to get more out of his bat. But he's got to make sure he doesn't press up there, or that average is gonna continue to go south.
Feeling a little nervous. I'm not gonna lie. It was the cough after my workout.
And he looks at the
screwball
that's over for strike one.
Well, Clyde Washington is very sporadic, I guess.
Good job against him in this series.
Not that my timing has been there, I admit that. But
sent on the ground out to second. Scope
not good contact.
On to first, two gone.
Two-pitch dribbler out.
These infielders have been busy early on, and that's another ground ball out for them. Probably not going to be the last one we see either.
Lee Ferrillo gets his first chance here, looking to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. First pitch of the at-bat. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat. Nothing and one. Well, you figure that curveball is going to be an important pitch for him going forward.
Yeah, I think it might even tell the story of how well he fares here tonight because he's going to need to mix his speeds against a lineup like this.
Way
once
high.
They start sitting on pitches, it could be trouble.
Thought I had better control than that, but... Well, it's 0-2.
Bases
what do I
are
care?
Empty here with two men out.
Ah, left it hanging.
Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again.
Jesus Christ. Should have been gone. So let's throw another fucking screwball, huh?
That misses 1-2.
Not too sure how you take that one on 0-2.
Yeah, not too sure how you call it a ball either.
Yeah, so this fucking...
Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. So nothing happening this time around. We'll go now to the top of the third. The Yankees are out in front, 3-0.
Okay. Mariznick is the number two. So
Jake
it's the 2-3-4 hitters.
Is into the box as we are all set to begin the third.
And they jumped out to that early lead, so now it's all about just adding on.
I didn't see what he did. Popped out.
And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
Thankfully, the stream
the
is just a little
guy
bit behind me.
For a first pitch curveball right there. If he gets it, he hammers it. If not, he's about 3 feet too late.
3 feet, that's terrible.
To short.
Dribbler, good pickup.
Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third.
Nice,
this ball
nice.
Is hit pretty sharply here towards
way
the
to
hole.
Back up your third baseman. That's
able
good
to
defense.
Backhand this thing and then use that cannon he's got to fire it across the diamond and get his man.
I mean, and he gloved it too. He could have went barehanded, been a tough guy. Let's work the count here. Come on, Abreu.
First baseman Jose Abreu now. Yes, he'll take a look at ball one.
Yeah, that's a good spot to miss against a guy like this. He loves that pitch up in the zone. Most power hitters do, so that's not a bad idea to give him one above the letters.
Hits it high and deep out to center field.
Oh,
Revere ranging back. He gets there, and that's the second out.
The fact that he turned around, all that thing was driving.
You can tell that it's October out there. There's a little bit of moisture in the air. Here, this ball sounded pretty good off the bat, and you wonder if it would have been a different story if it was mid-July out there.
Salvador Perez will try things again. He hit that two-run homer his first time.
Yeah,
well, we got him to 50 pitches here.
So let's see if he can get into another one in this at-bat.
Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one.
And it looks like he's rebounded pretty well from that rough inning a couple innings back. He put up a zero last time, and he's close to doing it again.
What are the odds that Perez goes yard again? Solo shot here.
Off the plate and in. Hits a ball and a strike.
I'd love it.
And he comes back with a fastball. One and two now.
Very patient here to start the at-bat. Maybe even a little too patient because now he's down one and two.
Yeah, and I don't think he's going to get anything better than that to hit.
One and two. Here it comes. Late making contact on that swing, and we'll do it again on one and two. Two out, nobody on.
Pitch 55 coming up. This is nice.
And a fastball. Tough take there, but it's even back at two and two.
Boy, that's a good take there. I don't think I could have laid off that one.
Washington's all over the place, though. Never know what kind of zone you're going to get from him.
Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch.
Should have been a strike.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue.
See that ship? Oh, boy,
into
way back
the
there.
Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over.
That was 57th
pitch. So the Yanks go 1-2-3. They lead it 3-0.
Yeah, 3-0, that's your fucking story. Mm-hmm.
Josh Harrison will dig in here, and it's been a series to forget for him so far, as you see the numbers there.
Got an RBI, though.
With these guys just one game away from going home, he may not have too many more opportunities to turn things around. He's got to make every at-bat count from here on out.
He may not have a lot going on.
A little bouncer. But it's foul, strike one.
Even still, I mean, you can look and say, hey, I got an RBI in a World Series. At the very least, kid.
And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's one and one.
Timing's not looking good today. Seems to be an issue, like usual.
Now a ball hit high and deep, heading toward the corner and left. But this will land foul just
that
shy of
the fucking slider again gets cracked. So let's avoid that, huh, catcher? Against righties, breaking it away.
Swing and a miss as he starts the third the same way he ended the second, with a punch out, one away.
That's a good pitch right there on a one and two pitch. You see that big old sweeping breaking ball. Tough to pick out a place where you can actually hit that pitch. It's moving so much.
Here's Ben Revere. As he'll take a called strike at the knees, it's 0-1.
Should have cracked
I tell
it.
You, he's got a good pace, a good tempo to him out there right now.
I like working fast.
Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. And he finds a way to catch the zone here. It's one and two. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at two and two.
That far off, huh? Boy, they don't want you to do well.
A breaking ball that time that he slaps
Fuck
the
me.
Other way out into left
Timing's
center.
Just
and it
off.
Falls
this
for
is
a base
bullshit.
Hit.
Not a bad guy to have hitting in your eight spot. That guy's no slouch up there and comes through with a solid single here.
Yeah, but he's got some wheels. And here's the pitcher, great.
Comes to the plate, possibly receiving a bunt sign in order to stay out of the double play.
Yeah, and everybody's got a different opinion on this situation. But in reality, it really comes down to how the pitcher is with the bat in his hand.
Thanks for switching, camera.
Second for one.
Well, we got the front man.
Yeah, you want to put this down
that
to the right side,
stupid.
Force that first baseman to field it, but
I wanted to run to first to help cover.
Hard, so that's a good decision defensively to go ahead and take the force at second.
Wow. Camera just bloop, bloop, bloop. I didn't know where the fuck I was running.
Starling Marte.
I look like a fucking idiot out there.
Out in his first trip.
And it was a breaking ball that seemed to fool him and induce that pop-up last time, so he may see a steady diet of those right here.
There you go. Get the, what? I'm assuming it's Petey the Pirate.
First pitch on its way. First pitch hacking here, and that's the first
Petey
strike.
The Pirate Bird. Petey the Parrot. That's it. Sure.
Oh. Off the plate. One ball, one strike.
I would not want a bird on my shoulder like that. Squawking in my ear. Making me go deaf. Shitting on one side of my suit.
Hang. One and two, and just 69 miles an hour on that breaking ball. That's barely moving.
A runner on first with two away.
Slider away.
That's a ball.
And a slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2.
Yeah, that's a great pitch on 1-2.
Little out there.
Started in the zone, and hopefully you'll get that guy thinking he needs to protect. It turned out to be a good take.
Fuck. God damn, the timing's off today. When they don't want you to win.
And now the benefit of you working the count to 3-2.
Fucking variable on this bullshit. It's too much.
Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning.
Screwball for the strikeout, thank God.
Pirates leave one.
MVP Baseball 2005 wasn't this fucking nutty on pitching. Timing was great there.
Mark Trumbo is ready here as we begin the top of the fourth. Right
fielder. What's the order here? It's Mark like Trumbo. Trumbo's what, the five batter? Maybe the six? Trumbo, Scope, Headley, Ahmed, Metzger. Doubt if we'll get that far.
And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one.
That's one of those fastballs that just never feels like it's going to be a strike. It's up at the letters, and that's a tough one to do anything with.
I'll start to speed things up when they don't talk. Three-run lead.
And he lays off for ball one.
Well, that's not a real favorable call for him right here. It's one thing when you're facing a lightweight hitter up there, but facing a guy like this, the difference between 1-1 and 0-2 is huge.
I'm sure it is. I'm on trouble work this guy. This will be 60 pitches right
here. Down low, two balls and a strike.
Nothing said, hit the button.
Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. A quick out number one.
Now we could hear him all the way up here in the booth. Just a big old... Oh, that's what pop-ups will make you do.
Well, I said fuck. A little different.
Digging in to try it again.
Maybe he heard
Jonathan
me.
Scope. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Well, at the very least, he went down hacking. Striking out is one of the many frustrations that go along with hitting, and you have to accept that it's going to happen sometimes.
Fastball in there for a called strike.
And I think now you're starting to get the sense that he's put that first inning behind him, and he looks a lot more comfortable out there now.
But he needs run support much like I needed
three
it in
runs,
game one.
Three hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball.
I wonder if the weather plays in how your pitch timing is. Because I don't seem on today.
Now a swing and a fly ball. And foul.
Good hustle, good effort. 1-2, though. He's got you here. Pitch 65 on the way.
For the second time. And here's a changeup in there for a called third strike, and that's the second out of the inning.
And he's having a rough
Scope, you still
so
look
far.
Like shit when we were in Baltimore, you know that?
You can see
your glove is all right.
That
that's about
outside,
it.
But, you know, I think once he gets
how the
a look
fuck
at
are we
it,
in the World Series with this lineup,
too.
Honestly? We get like one or two decent
so
guys.
Are empty here
Trumbo,
with two gone,
Headley,
and that'll bring in the
Scope.
Dangerous switch hitter Chase Headley.
Fucking, who's our catcher? It's no longer McCann. Salvador.
And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1.
God damn, like I got some congestion going on here. Like our best two batters.
Shot toward right center.
There we go.
And that finds some outfield grass. It's
damn.
A base hit.
Had that gotten there quicker, that's a double.
Well, he'd had some high-stress innings here so far. It was looking like he turned a corner and was on his way to a much-needed 1-2-3, but he's going to have to get in the stretch here after all.
Nick Ahmed is into the box, reached base via the walk in his first appearance.
Well, it's either there's two guys on for me, or I'll start the next inning.
Fastball here in a good spot, but ruled the ball 1-0.
I kind of like this, me being in the on-deck circle. That's kind of a unique little point of view.
Just missing here, 2-0.
Yeah, they're being really careful with this guy. Remember, they walked him the first time around, and now they're behind 2-0 to him right here.
70th pitch on its way.
Here's the 2-0. Chop foul right at home plate. It's strike one.
Almost hit me. God damn it. Fine and suspend that man.
Two out with the man at first.
The pitcher for throwing such garbage. Come on. What do we got?
Chop foul over towards the coaching box.
Come on, Nick. I don't know what I would. I'd like to get an RBI somehow, but.
And this runs inside, and that looked like it got him pretty good.
You don't really want to hit a guy, but part of the reason he's been in trouble so far is that he hasn't felt.
Yeah, I don't think that was intentional. You're down 3-0.
Guys lean out over the plate.
You don't
want
to get to me. What's the point in doing that? Just get this guy and let me be the easy out for the next inning. Now again, I want to protect low. And I'm going power.
Stepping in now, Derek Metzger. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one.
But I took a pitch. Yeah. I didn't just go first thing. No double play here, so I want to protect low, though. Uppercut this thing.
And that's in there as well. Owen
change
Tuna.
Up right down the
and
middle. It looked like it was high.
Right here. At least make
it dropped
some contact
in.
And force him to make a play.
Just don't strike at, well... Swing, if anything, Mike. Oh, boy, do we need to protect.
Set to deliver on nothing in two. Here it comes.
Why did
Heading
I even try?
Heading out toward shallow right. Polanco over to his left, and the inning is over.
Got scared.
Yanks strand a pair.
That was way up and
but
in.
They lead it 3-0.
I protected. Let me watch the stream. Ugh. Don't know if that would have been a ball, though, the way this fucking umpire's been.
Leading off the inning, Gregory Polanco, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
And right here is an important time for them to climb back into this one. They definitely want to even this one up sooner rather than later.
Now this get this shit out of the way. I can't fucking see here. Hide. And the camera up. View on all this shit. So fucking weird. Yeah, see, that could have been called a strike. So, I mean, I did idea. That was a protection swing. That would have been a strikeout had I not even taken the swing at it. So, I guess I did the right thing. What am I doing here? Thank you.
Couldn't hold up on the curveball there as he went around for strike one.
Nothing was said. I'll speed it up.
And he watches a called strike at the knees. No balls and two strikes.
Oh, and I like that he went right back to that curveball there.
It's in a hittable spot, though.
Yeah, you almost got him once. Try it again and see if he can hold off twice.
Now try the screwball.
Bounce towards the second baseman. Taken in by Scope. Throw to first.
Camera, why are you taking so slow to rotate here? I couldn't see if that thing was at my feet or not.
Catcher, Francisco Cervelli.
Sometimes just, here goes the ball. Here's the camera.
At the plate, Francisco Cervelli. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time.
Bring that slider in.
Now a dead slider middle. And he gets no ahead ball. Of him here.
Should have been crushed.
And against a guy
bad
like
timing,
this,
bad placement.
You're usually only going to get one pitch to hit in that bat. Sometimes you might not even get that, so that's one he may want back.
Bounce to the right into the loaded up infield.
Look how slow
Abreu
this is like.
Scoops it up, and he'll take this to the bag himself, and there
the
are two away
flying
now.
Past me.
Very quickly, five pitches and two outs here in the fourth. Well, those are the kind of innings you love to have if you plan on working deep into a ball game.
Oh, well, that was
John Jaso stands in. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out. First pitch coming. Here it is. In there at the knees. Strike one.
Good.
Bases are empty here with two men out. To first. Fielded by Abreu.
And
he'll
he's
step
out.
On the bag himself, and the inning
good.
Is over. Down in order go the Pirates. Still down 3-0.
Four down. Speed it up a little bit. Try to save
Dexter
ourselves
Fowler
a little bit of time.
Heads for the box to start off the fifth in this one.
And guys, this is the guy you want leading off this inning. He's your leadoff man, so maybe he can get things started. Set the table for a little bit of a rally.
And the first pitch of the inning here misses down and in for a ball. It's 1-0. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen.
Good. 76 pitches here in the fifth, yeah.
That evens it up 1-1.
If we get a couple people on base here, I think we'll get into that bullpen. Two runners on would be great.
Fastball called strike. 1-2.
Yeah, and it seems like he kind of got away from that pitch here in the last few innings. You got to think about bringing that one right back.
Like he reached up, the ball hit him right in the fucking chest. I thought it was a ball.
Grounder hit hard down the first baseline. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2.
Nice down the line, but... Well, this will be the 80th pitch. I mean, if anything, you worked them pretty good.
Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Good change up in the dirt, strike three. And he makes the throw to first. Fowler is retired, and there's one away.
Yeah, a nice job behind the plate. He wants it low, so he's got a good idea that this ball might be in the dirt, so he's able to smother it and then make the strong throw to first.
Okay.
Here's Jake
Marisnik. Here fifth. Working him.
As he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball 1-0.
Ground out and a pop out. Okay. The win here gives us a 3-1 series lead.
That's and he misses low with it, 2-0.
This guy has not been on his best stuff. I mean, all these pitches show. If we could get into their bullpen, that's going to wear them down for the long run of the series, I think.
And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1.
Yeah, you know, he probably got the fastball he was looking for, but on 2-0, you can look for one pitch in one spot. And if it's not in that spot, you take it.
Nope. 3-1. Four pitches. Fast, slow, fast, slow. EK, you thinking fastball here?
It seems to fit the pattern, but you better not get too predictable out there. Guys will catch on quick.
Saws him off here as this ball's popped into the air.
Lumber. Come on, kid, hurry up. We got shit laying on the field. He just gets the ball. What? Well, worked a full count out of this thing.
Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Good battle continues as this ball's chopped foul at the plate, and the count remains 3-2.
Keep him going, then. Run it up that much more.
He's ready. Now the payoff pitch. Smoked on the ground
nice.
Up the middle.
And pull his ass. Get him out of there.
Field for a one-out single.
Got a runner on here. 86, 87 pitches, something like that,
yeah,
with a runner
plenty
on.
Plenty to worry about now with only one out.
Get him.
Not only do you have a dangerous hitter on deck, but you've got a real speedster over there at first, so he could very well be on the move here.
The Mariznick has got wheels.
Jose Abreu will stand in. He flew out his last time up.
Yeah, but if he hits another double, could be another ribby. Get this guy out of here, I'm telling. Well, a double play would get him out of the fifth.
And he'll try to crowd him there to start the at-bat. It's 1-0. And you figure now this would be a spot where that man might try to take second base.
And it wouldn't be a bad idea to hold the ball a little longer out there on the mound. Really bury your times to the plate. You can't be predictable out there, or he'll take advantage.
Here comes the 1-0. That'll be a souvenir, and the count will move to 1-1.
This damn umpire.
Three runs, five hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far.
Pitch 90 coming up, but Washington's strike zone is all over the place.
Now we'll snap one off over to the bag. Runner's back.
What are you
doing? Keeping an eye on him.
Dude, worry about the batter. That's where your troubles have been all day.
Here comes the 1-1. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1.
That changeup away is his ground ball pitch. That's a good job to hold off.
Come on, camera.
Ready to deal. Here's the 2-1. Fastball is looked at for strike two.
I might want to see that. Looked a little low from here.
And a swing and a miss as they caught him reaching that time, and there are two away.
Damn it.
Let's analyze this swing on swing track. This pitch is away, but you'll see him swing inside the ball to try to pull it. You got to take that the other way.
Wow. That was fucking garbage. Well, 92 pitches.
Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike.
Had the two-run home run, but, I mean, still. Our lineup. Perez, Trumbo, Scope, Headley, they all stink.
Oh, one pitch on its way. And a pitch out. Nothing doing, though, and that's ball one.
Why worry about this? Perez had a two-run homer. I think you should be worried about him. Maybe it was a lucky shot. Who knows? Without it, you could be losing only one to nothing. So I would just worry about him and the fucking
the
base run on two outs.
Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2.
See? He's hacking at everything now.
A runner on
you got
first
him at
1-2.
Not that I wish it, but...
Now we'll step off the rubber and go to first. And he's back standing.
Stop it already. Come on, guys. Quit farting around on the mound. It rhymes.
And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
Yeah, get a new ball. That's the problem. Yeah. It's not you. It's the ball. Bum.
He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. Pitch is high. The throw. Not in time. He's in there
okay,
in second.
Okay, he went. All right. Fair
We've
enough.
We've seen him use his speed more than once here this postseason, and he's on the run again here as he gets into second with the stolen base.
Well, now he stole one, and he got caught. Yeah, but, okay, he's going again because it's a full count.
Good battle. Count remains full.
I'd be going. So I'm going to keep it locked here.
Has to be thinking strikeout here. Line towards center field.
Oh.
Revere is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. So no runs here on a base hit,
okay.
No errors, and one man left aboard. Last half of the fifth coming up. The Yankees lead it 3-0.
Okay, last part of the fifth.
John Rodon will stand in to lead things off here, and his guys have been unable to get anything going to this point.
Yeah, and you think so many times in the postseason, we see starting pitching really come to the forefront. And this guy's been every bit as good as advertised so far.
I've been okay. I lost game one. Still kind of upset about that, but Arrieta was on fire.
First delivery to him on the way.
Oh.
Breaking ball for a strike, 0-1.
Well, you get the sense that what they need is one big hit from anybody in the lineup. If they could get one, it could get them right back in this game, because right now they just seem out of it.
Late decision to swing that time, and as a result, it's 0-2.
It was kind of a delayed swing right there. He looked like he had to wait to see if it was going to be anywhere close, and now he's in a big hole.
And he reaches for one out of the zone and misses rather badly for the first out. A little bit over halfway home tonight, bottom of the fifth, as we get a look at our line score to this point. And boy, just one hit for these guys, and they have not swung the bats well. That's putting it mildly.
I believe you.
Lee Ferrillo is into the box. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Yep, they sent him packing last time, so maybe they have a pretty good idea of how to attack him again right here.
Are we good? Are we good? Good. And? Wow. That's terrible.
And he gets ahead with a screwball that's in there for strike one. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1.
I mean, that shit was like locked in on certain spots. It wasn't free-flowing.
One out, nobody on.
Wow.
Hit high and deep to straightaway right field. Back goes Trumbo. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out.
I was more worried that it was in the gap. It didn't look like it had fly-out distance, but fly-out power, fly-out distance, same thing.
Comes to the plate looking to put the ball in play. He went down on strikes last time.
Yeah, they got him on a breaking ball, so now we'll see
right here on one pitch.
Put him away with soft stuff again if they get that chance.
There's a strike at the knees, 0-1.
Well on his way to another good inning right here. And you see the pitch count. It's not even close to being a factor just yet.
Oh, and you talk about a pitcher getting the benefit of the doubt. That's low, but called a strike anyway. Nothing in two now.
Yeah, told you about Washington.
Now from getting through five shutout innings. And I'll tell you what, the way he's throwing, this could turn out to be a night off for the bullpen.
Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. So a strong start on the mound as he's blanked him through the first five. Five innings
blanked
complete.
The Yankees
lead this one 3-0.
He said it. I didn't. Come on.
Nestalí Feliz.
You were thinking
we'll get
it.
The call.
Here we go. Let's get into the bullpen now, boys. Let's fucking crack away at these guys. This will only help us in the series.
Mark Trumbo will start things out for the Yankees here in their half of the sixth.
Right fielder, Mark Trumbo.
Trumbo, Scope, Headley, Ahmed, and then Metzger.
First pitch of the inning is taken downstairs for a ball. It's 1-0.
Oh, baby Jesus.
That one's going to find the seats.
We'll let that one be a souvenir. Nice reach. Yeah, Washington's not the best umpire. This guy is fucking so sporadic.
Feliz is ready. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. And he takes a called strike two.
And you know what? These days, so many guys are throwing in the high 90s. It makes those mid to low 90s guys look easy. But I'll tell you what. If he mixes his pitches well, it can still be plenty fast to have to deal with.
They try to come in with the fastball, but it's too far in, and it's even at 2-2.
I think you have to ask yourself, was he trying to throw a fastball for a strike right there? Or was he just trying to set me up for that changeup away?
And this guy is a righty when I start taking swings, unless they switch pitchers
the
before.
Pitch. Tough fastball that time, but he hangs with it to stay alive.
Work him. Sixth pitch of this at bat.
Now a fastball inside, and he works it back to a full count now. One thing that man right there will not tolerate, leadoff walks.
Especially right out of the bullpen. This might be a quick outing if that happens.
Really? I mean, it would save his arm for later.
And they take him out of the zone here, and he obliges. Not the greatest
for
shit, swings
Trumbo.
There for the first out.
God damn it, the middle of this order
just
sucks.
A little more patient there. Would have had a leadoff walk. Instead, chases it out of the zone here and winds up costing him.
Well, who is up now? This is
here's Jonathan Scope now. And here's a slider that runs inside that time, and that'll keep him from diving out over the plate.
Bases, I mean, honest to God, Trumbo, Scope, and Headley, there aren't three worse batters on this team to have in a row.
Not close. It's 2-0.
Two tough sliders there back-to-back, and he couldn't get him to bite on either. Now he might have to change tack here, down 2-0.
I mean, Perez, Trumbo, Scope ain't good, but Headley is so fucking bad. I don't know why we brought him back.
A strike, and it's 2-1.
Maybe you worry about this guy getting a little too slider happy. That's three in a row now, so you're giving that guy at the plate a pretty good look at it.
Oh, boy. Scope has got a good glove. Headley's got a good glove, but sometimes that doesn't equate to runs. Taking some away, maybe,
set,
but...
And the 2-1 pitch to 2-2 now.
This is the Scope I remember in Baltimore. And remember, he got traded to the Yankees before I did. I was a straight-up trade for Tanaka.
Struck him out.
No.
Continue as that's his third strikeout of the game.
He was part of the Tanaka trade. I was traded straight
that's
up for Castro. That's
here.
Right.
Third strikeout.
My bad.
One thing you can't do, though, you can't go into that dugout hanging your head. You got to think, hey, it's over. I'll get another shot to redeem myself. Whether that's tonight or sometime in the future, that's the attitude you have to have.
Yeah, but, you know, a fucking hat trick
here's
of strikeouts.
Batting left-handed here as he takes a look at strike one.
Headley's a switch hitter and he sucks. I mean, come on, that single that he got, for Christ's sakes, probably put his batting average up, you know, 400 points. He's just not good.
He's set. Here's the 0-1. And a fastball way off target here, and it's even at 1.
So he had that one good year in San Diego. Then when I heard the Yankees got him whatever season that was, I was like, oh, good for them. A good, you know, third baseman hasn't done a thing.
Way outside, nearly to the backstop, 2-1.
Unless he's a disciplined batter, fine, take a walk, but...
Two-one pitch is a fastball swung on and missed 2-2. Living a little dangerously here.
Yeah, you don't have to go looking for trouble. Trouble will find you if you're putting pitches there.
Yeah, but it's Headley, so you don't have to worry about it, really.
Looking to set down the side on strikes. Here it comes.
Back to work.
Struck him out, so he makes quick work of him here. Three straight strikeouts, and the side is retired. Three up, three down, three strikeouts. Not too shabby. Back with more of Game 4 on the show after
how
this.
The fuck does their bullpen relief pitcher
ben
coming
Revere
in strike out
come
the
in
fucking
now to
side?
Start things out here in their half how? Of the sixth as they look for a reversal of fortunes here. The first five innings have not been particularly kind to them.
Yeah, Trumbo, Scope, and Headley. I suppose that's
just
how, but Jesus, fuck.
First five innings.
That's just
to do a better
that's
job
how shitty this lineup can be for
hit.
Us.
But that fellow on the mound has not made it easy on him, and that's for sure.
Okay, let's just get to work here.
8,
hopefully
9,
we can do better.
To start the inning as the first pitch misses for ball one. Double-barreled action in the Yankee bullpen now. A lefty and a right-hander start to get loose. Swing and a ball chop foul right at home plate. And he looks at
good.
One in there, 1-2.
And if he's had any postseason jitters, he hasn't shown them to me.
Now, he's been outstanding so far.
Grounded to short.
But
there is Ahmed. And a good throw gets him one gone.
Four pitches, get him the fuck out of here. That 90 speed, I do not want that on the base path.
Much has changed here to start this inning either. That's eight in a row now he's set down.
Good.
Carlos Santana will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 41.
Well, there you have it.
Santana.
Told you, that guy was a righty. The reliever.
Lying
good
toward
shot.
The gap in left Fuck center. Me. Solid base hit for him, his first of the afternoon.
Yeah, and guys, there's a look at his line through the first few innings.
Two hits.
Pretty dominant so far. Just the second hit he's allowed tonight. And the first one didn't wind up hurting him at all. So we'll see if he can get out of this inning as well.
Fucking Marte.
Starling Marte.
Got the speed.
Will stand in, and he, like so many others, hitless in the ballgame so far.
Well, we've been talking about it a lot, but this offense is just getting shut down right now. And we've seen some really fantastic pitching in this one.
And the ball 1-0. Not the first time he's felt the squeeze tonight.
Yeah, he's looking and saying, what do I got to do to get a strike?
I'll give you $20.
Runner at first here, one man out. Swing and a miss, one and one.
I signed a big contract before the year started. I'll give you $20 to make that a fucking 0-2 count right now. What do you say?
Swung on and missed, one and two now. Pretty clear the plan is to keep everything away.
And that's smart for most guys, but you've got to know your scouting report because this is a guy that can cover the outside part of the plate.
Jam
and
him
here's
up
a ball
again.
Hit in the air. There to take it is Abreu, and that's out number two.
Good.
Boy, his guy's got him the lead back in the very first inning, and he hasn't looked back since. He's had everything go his way so far, and this inning's turning out to be no exception.
Gregory Polanco. We'll dig in for a third time now. He's popped out and grounded out so far.
I'm not getting strikeouts. Why are we putting
from
it right
the
in the red zone?
Here's the pitch. And he looks at the screwball that's over for strike one.
Not getting strikeouts today, but again, really a changeup in his zone.
Good arm action on the circle. Change swung on and missed 0-2.
A strike away now from getting through six shutout innings here, and that's no small feat against this lineup.
Same shit. Are you kidding me?
Chop foul at the plate, and he stays alive, still 0-2. 0-2, here it comes. Gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. Swing and a miss. Got him with the screwball, and the side is retired.
Yes, yes, yes.
One left for Pittsburgh. They trail it here 3-0.
Six innings done. Three more. And we take a 3-1 series lead, if that be the case. I'll get swings this inning.
Is on the pitch now as he'll take over to start inning number seven.
Archimedes, that's a fucking dope-ass name. That is that's one of the best names in baseball right there. Caminero.
Nick Ahmed will stand in here to start the seventh in a game that's been sailing along to this point.
Yeah, good thing we don't get paid by the hour, man. This game has flown by.
Yeah. Well, you're welcome, boys. All right, I'm on deck.
And a high strike there, 0-1.
Just no chance to pull the trigger on that one. It just got on him too fast.
I kind of like this over the shoulder, this POV, whatever. This voyeuristic view.
The 0-1. Good hard slider there, but it runs away. It's a ball and a strike. And he'll fall behind now to 1-2.
Oh, if you can get on base, that'd be great. I'd love to get a ribby somehow.
Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. Fastball call, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
This bullpen's picking right up where their starter left off. This has been a real team effort on the mound so far.
Well,
Derek Metzger will stand in again. He's flown out in each of his first two plate appearances thus far.
What does this guy do?
Yeah, and he just needs
four
to make
seam,
a small adjustment.
Slider coming in. Splitter will drop
ball.
Straight down. Changeup will drop straight
right
down.
Back up the middle.
I'm protecting down.
Here comes the first pitch. Oh. Fastball off the plate away. It's ball one.
Excuse me. Protecting down is just my thing. That was in there either way. No big deal.
Very difficult to get on top of a pitch when it's coming in that high.
Smoke, son.
Darn near impossible when it's coming at you in the high 90s. You just can't get your hands up there fast enough to stay on top.
Power swinging, that thing dropped.
One and two now.
Okay. You got me. I got to protect like a motherfucker.
This is hit the other way out toward left
now
field.
Now I fly out the
Marte
left.
Is over. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
Well, I've flown out to right twice and out to left.
I think I can tell you why. If you're not a power hitter, you need to hit down on the ball. Try and drive things. This guy doesn't have enough muscle to hit home runs consistently, so he's wind up as routine flyouts.
Consistently? I hardly hit him. Oh, well.
Dexter Fowler. Ready to take another shot. Went down on strikes his last time up.
Fowler, let this first one by, please.
Last time, and I wouldn't be surprised to see them try to work that off-speed stuff right back into their game plan here.
Chop weakly to the left.
No, you fucking...
Gung is up with it.
Should have been 10 pitches, not 9.
The side is retired.
I want to work through this damn bullpen.
But they're on top by a count of 3-0.
All right, back to work. Bottom
Francisco
seven.
Francisco Cervelli will stand in again. Coupled of ground outs for him on the ledger in his two trips so far.
Yeah, just sort of rolling over on it, guys. See if he can make a small adjustment and get through one here.
Starting on a changeup, I don't like this.
To the right, here's the first pitch. They haven't played perfectly as it's hit on the ground. Ahmed has it, and he retired one away.
One pitch out, that'll work for me.
This isn't always the way you want to play it here. I mean, it's late in the game. Your guys are losing.
Is it raining?
Wouldn't be such a bad idea to take a pitch or two.
No, oh, just something weird with that green background.
The very first pitch, and it's an easy out.
It looked like
John Jaso will stride forward now. He's bounced out a couple of times already here in the ball game.
Just a little off on his earlier swings, guys. You've got to keep that top hand palm up through contact to keep him rolling over.
One strike.
And he just keeps rolling along as he starts another batter out with strike one.
Fanning
well, he's really
down.
Kept himself in the game here by throwing first pitch strikes to about 70% of the batters he's faced. That's kept him in the ball game and kept his team in the ball game.
Hard
good curveball, strike two.
Yeah, ground ball out to start the seventh. Now an 0-2 count. He's looking sharp as ever.
One out, nobody on. A little bit off the outside. It's 1-2. High in the air out to center field. Fowler is there.
Under it.
Two down.
Two down. That was four pitches, so five pitches for two outs here.
Now batting, third baseman, Jung Ho Gong.
Jung Ho Gong will come in now with two away, and to this point at least, so much for having the 3-4-5 guys get the rally started.
Yeah, it's been an important inning for that man out there on the mound.
71
He's
pitches. We're
ground,
doing good on pitch count here.
He made it through the teeth of this lineup, still holding on to that lead.
As long as we stay in the 70s through the seventh. Come on, controller, let's not lag here.
And this one's not close. It's in the dirt for ball one. Two out, nobody on.
Yeah.
And that's in there for his strike 1-1.
Looked like there was my neck. That was really weird.
Oh, he had a hanger, but he missed it. It's 1-2. Still no fastballs in the at-bat. It's been
all
off-speed.
It looks like there's something glitching off my head. Like this beam of light shining off my ear. Or something.
Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for a ball. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Mariznick is under it. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning.
10 pitches
one, two,
to get out of the inning.
The Pirates. They trail in this one 3-0.
End of the seventh. All right, guys.
Leading off the inning, Jake Mariznick.
Not the insurance runs, but I'll take them.
Insurance before the bottom half of the inning. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Sends that one out of play for strike one.
Damn, Washington. Sporadic umpire.
Set to deliver the 0-1. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2.
Yeah, not a good start here. I mean, 0-2, he's kind of got you.
Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
Yep.
A couple of good pitching performances by both clubs here. 3-0 our score as you get a look there at the inning-by-inning recap through the first 7
But see, when we bat at the top of the first, I can't do play-by-play. I can't watch game. It's just like an automatic thing.
Jose Abreu, ready to try again. Struck out swinging.
So
in his
somewhere
last
in my brain, it's nothing because I didn't see it happen.
Time, so
simulation or pitch
again.
By pitch here. So I kind of hate that.
And that's taken high.
San Diego Studios. There's another fucking flaw. You need to get that shit fixed.
And this winds up inside for a ball. 2-0 now.
And on 2-0, this is where he's the most dangerous up there. I know it's a fastball count, but I would maybe think about something else.
2-0, here it is. In there, 2-1.
Archimedes Caminero. That's a great fucking name. Just beautiful.
Skied into very shallow right. Polanco is under it, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning.
The catcher, number 13,
Salvador Perez, strides into the box now, launched one over the wall back in the opening frame.
All right, Sally. That's perfect. A guy playing for the Yankees, his name's Sal. Huh? That's perfect.
Into the seats, 0-1.
All we need now is maybe a guy named Ira. You might find a guy named Sal out in, like, fucking Chicago. A bunch of Italians out there, too. Not that Salvador Perez is Italian, but...
That's taken. Now
that's
it's
what they would call him.
Really a good job so far by this guy out of the bullpen.
Yeah, he's come in and really put his stamp on this game. Throwing a lot of strikes. That's what you want.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Frozen for strike three, and that retires the side.
Well, fair enough. Let's
get
to work. The
Yanks go 1-2-3. They lead it 3-0. Lee Ferrillo will stand in to start out their half of the eighth with that starter still out there, and he's definitely been a tough nut to crack.
No, he's been dominant all game long, and I think part of it is that he got himself a nice lead early on, and that's allowed him to not really worry about making a mistake. He's been free and easy the whole way through.
0-1. They got me that lead. I didn't even see it happen.
Now, the guy you see right there has been terrific. But will they let him work these final two innings?
Well, I think
the goddamn well better.
In his favor. Everybody pays a lot of attention to that. So barring a huge spike right here in the eighth, I don't see any reason why you can't get these final six out.
Save the bullpen.
Time, and that's out number one.
If they get two runs on the board, then I'd start thinking about using the bullpen.
Right along. Shut out intact as you get a look at his line so far. Through 7 1/3 innings now, they have just not been able to mount any type of offense against him at all.
And only 6 strikeouts. Timing has not been good
Josh
for me
Harrison
today.
Digs in. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there.
Why?
And he gets
what even jinxed me like that, dude? It's the eighth inning.
One.
I got a complete game shutout going. Just fucking... All right, have him warm up. I don't want to hear about it. How about that?
Tap fouled at home plate.
Good. And now swing over this one.
And the 0-2 pitch. And he struck him out. And there's the hat trick, as that's his third strikeout of the ballgame.
But that was the slider.
Can't ask for much more out of a starting pitcher. Working on a two-hit shutout right now.
Ben Revere,
and I don't walk anybody.
Stand in now with two away, needing to really get something started here.
And their chances of getting back into this ball game are growing dimmer by the batter.
You know, I say it frequently enough. Come on, troll the fuck out! I swear to God, it should be flowing real quick. Not do.
Here's the first pitch to him.
Then I know my pitch time is going to be way off, because when I hit the button, it's not going to register in time. Really fucking annoying.
Swing and a little tapper. Foul ball, however, strike one.
But I will say it again. I have yet to accidentally hit a batter.
Two out, nobody on.
Even my sometimes poor control.
Now a screwball is poured over for a strike, and he takes command one and two.
And I say accidentally because I've beamed people. You know, hit a home run off of me. We're still up 4-1.
Well hit. Deep down the right field line. And he will get there to make the running play.
Beautiful.
And that will end the inning. Can't ask for much more than this. Eight shutout innings thus far. We're through eight full here in game four. It's the Yankees 3 and the Pirates nothing.
End of the eighth.
Welcome back to Major League Baseball on the show from Pittsburgh, PA. Ninth inning about to start in this one. Mark Trumbo will stand in now to lead things off, and he'll do so with the same pitcher still out there. Seems he's earned himself another inning.
Mark, I think that's a definite vote of confidence, but he's done a nice job since coming in, so you might as well ride that hot hand.
Well, if we can work this guy up to 30 pitches, that would be nice. 10 per. Maybe we can get him more, but, yeah, the bridge way out there beyond the green wall. Was that the one in that
He's
cinematic
ready.
Cut?
Here's the first offering. Ninth inning begins as the first pitch is taken for ball one. Grounded up the first baseline. To his left, Gossel.
Oh,
and he'll take this to the bag of three unassisted for the first out.
Now batting, second baseman.
Okay.
Jonathan Schoop stands into the box. He could really use a knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far.
Captain strikeout. He's going for the golden sombrero here. He's got the hat
Ready
trick already.
Deliver. Here's the first pitch.
Oh.
In tight here with the first pitch fastball that's 1-0.
Archimedes Caminero. That's fucking great. What a great name. Even the spelling.
That's wide, 2-0.
I should name my kid Archimedes. Some one of those cool fucking Grecian mythology names. Grecian and Roman, whichever it is. I don't know.
There, but he couldn't connect 2-1.
And after
like Socrates,
already,
even though he was real.
Be pressing up there at the plate, trying to make something happen.
And Archimedes, whatever. You know what I'm
might
saying.
Make things worse.
Some of them old dope-ass names from Tales of Lore and such.
And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two.
A little conviction behind that fastball.
You know, we got enough Mikes walking around, right?
Bases
we need
are
more
empty,
Archimedes walking. Mortimer, right? We need some of those names, those turn-of-the-century names.
And he struck him out again. So that's the old sombrero there, partner. Four strikeouts in the ballgame.
Jesus
you
fucking
what, if you're
Christ,
to this
Scope.
Guy right now, you might want to turn away from the screen because this is going to be tough to watch. Here they are, one after another. That's four strikeouts for him, and that's called the golden sombrero.
And again, Scope. You, Headley, hit a home
Here's
run.
Here's Chase Headley. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one.
Okay, so not exactly Mr. Burns, and he's not exactly Daryl Strawberry, but come on.
Ball. Up top, it's 2-0. Bases are empty here with two men out.
Now,
2-1 after
even
the
if Headley gets
there.
On and Ahmed gets on, do they keep me in? Or would they get a pinch batter and then bring in fucking Chapman to close out?
Set to deliver on 2-1. Bullet back up the middle, and that'll get down.
Getting closer
for a
to finding out. A complete game shutout, though. Don't hook me.
You know, as a hitter, you're seeing the ball so well. When you can take a pitch like that and square it up and just hammer it right back up the middle.
Well, that's two hits for Headley today, isn't it? As I stand on deck.
Into the box now, Nick Ahmed. As the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike.
Nick Ahmed kind of has that Derek Jeter, that front toe on the ground type. The heel up.
Two out with the man at first. And he takes strike two.
Really?
And he struck him out. So a good pitch there. And now they're
what
going to need
the
to
mother
spring
hey, at least I put my shit in the outfield.
Bat if they want to get
you
back
guys,
in this thing.
Swinging it shit all in close.
But they lead it 3-0.
Some guy's reaching way out for it. At least I'm making contact and putting the shit in play. It's not a foul ground pop out.
For the Pirates, number 22, Wyatt Reese.
Is this thing, come on.
And he takes a pitch that's ruled a strike at the knees. Pretty liberal strike zone there. It's 0-1.
And this might be one of those situations where if you've been around the plate a lot, umpires, they'll reward you with a call that you maybe wouldn't have gotten earlier.
And he gets him to swing through that one. He's in control, 0-2.
He's feeling it now. I mean, this is turning into a clinic out there.
Shot foul at the plate, and we'll do it again.
Even with perfect timing.
Swinging a liner back through the box. And that's going to be a base hit, so a great job off the bench.
With 89 speed, and he's
going
to try to steal, and then they'll fucking run him in.
Tonight that they've had their
on a base hit or a double or some shit.
Now they've got to find a way
and
to
get pulled.
On it if they want to get back in this thing.
Get credited with fucking...
Starling
two
Marte
runs. Chapman will give up the third. It'll be tied. We'll lose it next.
Keeping him
you know.
Base at the top of the lineup. He's 0-3 thus far.
Yeah, guys, not really providing the spark that they usually hope to get out of him. Maybe he can make something happen right here.
Yeah, we see a lefty and a right-hander start to
bring
loosen
it
up in the bullpen. And he looks at the screwball that's over for strike one.
I worry about
nobody out, runner on first. Swing and a miss, and he's in control, 0-2.
And this has been a common problem for all of these guys. They just can't lay off that pitch down and away.
Got him. And that's 8 strikeouts now for him in the ballgame.
Good, I needed
that
one.
Not only has he rung up a lot of strikeouts, but he still hasn't walked a batter to this point. So his control has been really, really spot on so far.
Here's Gregory Polanco. And he'll take a tough pitch on the outside part of the plate for strike one.
That was not a
pretty
tough pitch on the outside
here
part.
Coming out of that left-handed batter's box, so it's no sure thing that a ground ball means a double play.
Runners on first with
too.
One down. Barely able to make contact.
Strike
down
two.
0-2 now. Oh, he's really got the strikeout pitch working now as he notches number 9 in the ball game.
Well, 9 so strikeouts, one per inning, not bad.
Doesn't seem to have affected him one bit. Come back with the 2 straight strikeouts, and now he's turned things around in this inning.
Francisco Cervelli will stand in now as their last shot here with 2 away in the 9th.
Yeah, just one final hurdle here before he finishes off the shutout.
Oh, okay. So
he's set. Here it comes.
no stealing ability thingy. Frozen,
strike one.
And this offense has just been stuck in neutral. Even when they get a guy on to start the inning, they've got nothing to go with it.
Swing and a miss, and with that, the Bucks are down to perhaps their final strike of the ball game. Looking for his 10th strikeout, and he gets strike three called to end it here, and with that, this one is over.
Well, we've talked about it all throughout.
Complete
this game
shutout, and we take a 3-1 series lead.
And now he finishes
much
off
needed.
A masterful performance here, getting the complete game shutout.
I did miss a text or something. People wondering if I'm working today, seeing that it's Memorial Day. Of course I'm working.
Time for one final check of the line score as you see the key players there in this shutout victory.
Now that I think about it, it's actually Marlins Pirates today. Game was supposed to be played in Puerto Rico, but the Zika has everybody scared, so they're going to play it here in Miami. I think that's a 6:40 game and a 7:10 first pitch. Sounds about right.
And guys, you can't win if you can't score,
Ten
so
strikeouts.
There's probably not a whole lot of debate about who'll take home Topps Player of the Game honors in this one.
Yeah, he definitely turned in the standout performance in this one. He finishes with an even 10 strikeouts, and he was instrumental in leading his guys to the victory.
The music in this game is the drizzling shits. Just not good. I am not a fan of it at all. However, to get through the animation of me being player of the game, I'll look at it. And that's
so it. So that's a wrap here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. And for more, click on over to theshownation.com. The Yankees come out on top, 3-0.
Yeah, and I didn't even
Good
see the runs because
Pittsburgh.
It all happened in the top of the first. In my brain, this game is still nothing. But we won it, so whatever. What can I do about that?
Our final line score tonight, first for the victorious Yankees. 3 runs, 6 hits, no errors. They left 5 men on base. For the Pirates, no runs, 3 hits, no errors. They left 3 men on base.
The three hits.
Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 36 minutes.
Didn't take me that long.
Tonight's paid attendance at PNC Park, 38,365.
38?
The Pirates thank you for attending tonight's game and remind you to please drive home safely.
That's not that good for attendance, 38,000. Well, PNC holds better than that, doesn't it? Hey, look at that. Took everybody out in the ninth inning on strikeouts. Booyah, motherfucker. Good. Well, could be a moment of truth here. So what I'm going to do... Well, let me check training perks. Where's my... Control is all at 80. I would like everything to get up to 90, but that takes about 2,000 per. Jesus Christ. That's a lot. Batting doesn't matter. Well, if nothing's yellow or red, I'm not going to worry about it too much. Anyway, what am I thinking here? I'm going to save right now. Which is a little different than my regular, but bear with me. This might be important. Okay, the reason why I'm saving it out, normally I'll save just before my start. But see, I don't know when my next appearance is going to be. Now, on paper, Nick Mueller they want in that game? Are you shitting me? You gotta be... Come on. You gave me game 1, 2, 3 days off and started me. 1, 2, 3 days off, and you should start me here. See, this is really stupid, but I want to simulate until next appearance, just in case they put me in a bullpen scenario But weigh in. So far it's Chen, Severino, and Mueller do up in these games. And we're just going to give her hell here. Play next appearance. The Yankees won the World Series. So we lost game 5. We won game 6 right there, I do believe. Oh, God damn it.
Hi there, everyone. Welcome to this special postseason edition of Inside the Show. Let's take a look at the latest from around Major League Baseball. The New York Yankees sank the visiting Buccos 6-2.
So we lost Chen's game 3-0. And we ended up winning. Mueller got the win. I thought he was going to get the start there. But he gets the win. 7 strikeouts. And a 6-game series, we win the World Series. Wow. Well, that's fun. Any extra points there? A little bit. We won the World Series, everybody. In my 3rd year, World Series champion. Awards. World Series MVP, Aaron Hicks. Really? San Diego Studios, you're full of fucking shit. Batting 500 with no home runs, no ribbies. How the fuck is he World Series MVP? Please tell me that. It's kind of like reliever of the year, Tanner Scheppers, with 2 strikeouts, no saves, no ERA, winning the reliever of the year award. And still, he's not even with the fucking Texas Rangers, he's with the whoever Express. You can see the logo beneath his name. Express. Who the fuck is this guy with, and why, with no saves, does he win reliever of the year award? If there's one fucking thing that San Diego Studios needs to sharpen up, it's their goddamn awards. Because that's fucking bullshit. This guy didn't even get a save. He wins reliever of the year. No, in the National League, K-Rod, 48 saves, 56 strikeout. That makes sense. This guy, what the fuck? Give me a break. How does this guy win World Series MVP? What did he do? Not even a ribby. How the fuck do you win MVP without driving in a single run? You're a bench player. No ribbies. World Series MVP. I don't know about that one. That's disgusting because there were better batters on our team. Contract, Twitter, morale. That's it. I can't check, like, playoffs or nothing. Because even at, like, I wasn't expecting to win it because there's really no... Yeah, see, postseason MVP. They give it to Salvador Perez. Could have been me. Should have been me, I think. Who contributes the most to his team's success during the postseason. You would think that would have been me. Okay, fine. But, really, 2 ribbies and he wins it? No ribbies and this guy wins World Series MVP? Flawed. This is horrendously flawed. So, okay, I guess I can't look at that for fucking whatever. Can't get any solace out of that. Wow. But, I mean, look at this. 4 wins. Chapman had 5 saves. 53 strikeouts. Okay, a 1.05 ERA. I don't know about that, man. Is this in the season? 4 wins. Had a loss. That's fine. 5 saves. Really? This was it in the American League? 8 total saves? Wow, that's weird. ERA, 1.05. Home runs allowed? Yeah, I allowed the 1. Mm-hmm. Shutouts, 1. Strikeouts, 53 in 43 innings. Complete games, 3. Innings pitched, 43. Walks allowed. Did I hit somebody? I must have hit 2 people, apparently. Okay, fair enough. Whip of 0.47. You gotta be shitting me. Pitching war, 1.78. Batting war, look at this. Ahmed Mariznick. Salvador Perez. Dexter Fowler. Jonathan Scope. Oh, there's Hicks. A batting war of 0.14. Now, was this all the postseason? The entire postseason, he had 16 appearances. On-base percentage, 421. Okay, fine. Nick Ahmed didn't win it. When he had 6 ribbies. Okay, Mariznick, 4 runs. That's pretty impressive. That means you're actually getting some hits. Yeah, especially because Ahmed had way more fucking at-bats. Mariznick could have been the MVP. Well, but that's, you know, at least for the fucking playoffs. Anyway. So they need to sharpen up that shit. Well, we won the World Series. And I was thinking this the other day, where, okay, I was runner-up in Rookie of the Year. I've won the Cy Young, I've won the MVP. I've now... I've won the pennant. I've won the World Series. It's kind of like, where do I go from here in this career of Derek Metzger? Because, you know, that's only my third year completed. Third year, okay? It's not like I did a lot of fucking years in the minors. No, no. This is my third year fully completed. A two-month call-up from AA. The Orioles brought me up. I stayed there the remainder of the first year. That's where I was runner-up in the Rookie of the Year. Midway through that second season, right after the All-Star break, I requested a trade. Ended up with the Yankees. From there, won the Cy Young and the MVP, and we got to the ALCS, where I pitched 27 innings and allowed one run. This third year, all with the Yankees, another Cy Young, another MVP, 366 strikeouts on the year. Beautiful record. We go through and win the World Series. What do I do from here? You know, it's kind of, it almost sounds arrogant, but, you know, I got to get through this career yet. Don't know how much further we're going to. What am I looking for right now? I need... Oh, no, I'll check, not even standings. Yeah, sure, give me some league leaders here. Let me go back to this. I was looking at it, but I didn't make note of it. 20 years old is Derek Metzger. 20 years old. Is he Baltimore? Total of 2017, because it was split between Baltimore and the Yankees. And then the 2018 season. Ugh, look at that. Back-to-back 20-win seasons. Really upped the strikeout total from 273 to 366. ERA under 1. A whip from 0.7 to 0.6. We did pretty good. But yeah, 20 years old. It was what? 18, 19, and 20 years old. What more can I do? Well, we got a long ways to go. We really do. Once I get out of arbitration, there's all that stuff to worry about. So let me sim through the date. Can I do that? Advance to the offseason. There we go. Are you sure you want to advance? Yes. View retired players. Well, this is a fun thing. Augustin Chavez, AJ Ellis, Lee James, Clay Buchholz is gone. Travis Ishikawa. Hanley Ramirez is gone. Aw, the 21-year-old girl at the club with the bleach blonde twist dreads. At age 35, you're gone. Too fucking bad. Too fucking bad for Hanley Ramirez. Edwin Encarnacion is gone. J.A. Happ is gone. Henry Broussard. I'm trying to look for the big names. Victor Martinez. I always liked him. 40 years old. Yeah, that would do it. Anibal Sanchez. Gone. Edinson Volquez. Gone. Irvin Santana. Albert Pujols, poor free agent market, gone. 2017 to 2018, nothing happened. Dude, he almost got the 600 home run club. Oh, that's brutal. No one picked this guy up. Overall of 56, now I understand. Wow. Ryan Madsen. Nelson Cruz is gone. Cole Hamels at 35 is gone. Nick Markakis, 35 years old, put in 13 years, okay. What is this going by? What team is this going by? John Ramos. John Ramos, isn't he with Jay Moreshore on Fox Sports Radio? 24 years old, poor free agent market. No one's signing my ass. Brian McCann went to the Cubs, okay, so he ended up there. But, sorry to see you go, kid. He was a decent catcher all around. Chase Utley, 40 years old, finally gone. Ended up with Milwaukee. Josh Chase, Howard Rivera. Adam Wainwright, 37 years old and gone from the Cardinals. Adrian Gonzalez. Woof. What did he end up with? 373 home runs. Yeah, I mean, he kind of had his time in the sun. From 2007, 2008, 2009, 2010. And then he started dipping below the fucking... the 30 home runs. He had 2016, 36. But had a decent little stretch there. Brandon McCarthy. Corey Seager. Was this the guy? 24 years old and you're... Oh, torn Achilles tendon. That sucks. Oh, that sucks. James Shields. Where do I remember him from MVP Baseball 2005? Well, maybe I didn't. Okay, but a longtime Tampa Ray. Denard Span, I know the name. Was he always... No, he jumped around a bit. Henry Abreu. Well, and these are just free agents. This should be fun. Because who knows where these guys ended up. Andres Blanco. Whew. Yeah, kind of jumped around. Bit of a journeyman. Joe Blanton. I remember that name. Pitcher for Oakland back in the day. Michael Bourne. Yeah, kind of a journeyman in his own right. Reed Brignac. Justin Brown. Randy Brown. Carrera Carroll. Cash. Pedro Cedeno. Chris Coughlin. Wasn't he a Marlin? Yep. And a Cub. Chris Colabello. Gone. Who else retired? Ross Detweiler. Marlin? No, just Washington. Played the Marlins a lot. That's how I know the name. Feldman, Fletcher, Ramon Flores, Enes Fuentes, Gentry, German Gomez, Tom Gorzolani. Wow. Put in enough time, 36 years old. Ubaldo Jimenez, he was the Rocky that went to Cleveland. Never really had that great success. Remember he had that one badass year with Colorado. It had to be this one, 19-8, in Colorado. Okay, 221 innings pitched, 214 strikeouts, pretty good. When you're close to that ratio, pretty fucking good. Jim Johnson, Chris Johnson, a lot of Johnsons, giggity. Adam Lind. This fucking guy. Looked like a tree-chopping son of a bitch. Had the man's beard going. I'm yawning, I know. Marquez Milano, Malone, Mitchell. Brandon Morrow, I know the name. Bunch of years in Toronto. Charlie Morton, Moss Mueller, I know. Mike Napoli gone. Kirk Nieuwenhuis, 31, I thought he was older than that. Wow. Ricky Nolasco, 36, a Marlin, yeah. You know, when you live down here and you work for a radio station that airs the Marlins game, you tend to remember a lot of these names. Bud Norris with Houston, okay, he's gone. Boy, just sad to see some of these names, like, just retiring for, you know, poor free agent market. Smolinski, Snyder. Tidwell, Valentin, Vargas, who else? EY Jr. is gone. Bunch of years in Colorado. 33 years old. Bad free agent market. Oh, and that's it. So, there's your retirees, everybody. Are you sure you'd like to exit the retirement screen? Yes. Albert Pujols, a Hall of Famer. Just shy of the 600 club. 1,800 fucking ribbies. 100 stolen bases. I would have not guessed that. He seemed like a big guy, you know? Are you sure you want to exit? Yeah. Okay, I'm going to save right now because contract. So, let me get to the calendar. View contract offers nothing yet. So, let me sim through this date. Contract offers nothing yet, so sim through it now. Contract offer. Nothing, really? Whoop, view offers. Now, the Yankees are giving me a one-year offer of $2.8 million. Now, that's not bad. Let me just sim through the offseason, just to see if I'm able to do... I don't think I'm free agent eligible. Offered you salary arbitration. Since you have less than 6 years of service, you must accept. You may continue to negotiate a contract until your arbitration hearing in February... You will be asked to submit a salary figure before the hearing takes place. Okay. So can I... They offer 1.2. Well, give me... Or sorry, 2.8. Well, straight up give me 3. They've accepted. Well, I don't want that, because if I'm able to get some kind of arbitration and get, am I able to be free agent is my question. That's what I'm looking to check right now. So what I want to do... View offers. All right, so they're at, giving me a 1 year, 2.7. Let's run up here. Let's just be a dick and ask for 4. That's my offer. The Yankees have refused your offer and countered with a 1 year, 2.875. Well, let me cancel because I put my offer on the table. So what did they say? In February is the fucking arbitration date or something? Like, sim through the date. Now it's going to tell me again, they've offered me salary arbitration since you have less than 6 years, blah, blah, blah. We hear all that. Now, view offers. They're still offering 2.7. Let me just go to the 4. They have refused and they're offering just under 3. Okay, fine, but would you like to sign? Cancel. That's the number I want, so... Let me just get through these days. Where's the arbitration day, I wonder? Oh, you must choose the salary figure that you would like to submit for your arbitration. Previous salary was 2.3. Well, fuck, give me 3 then, right? Submit an arbitration figure of 3 million. Once this offer is made, it will be final. Cancel. No, let's go to 4 then, just to be a dick. Your offer has been submitted to the arbitration panel. You may continue to negotiate a contract until your hearing in February. Okay, so let's... I just want to play this out to see if this is anything, You won your arbitration case. Your salary for 2019 will be $4 million. Wow. Like, I don't really want to do that. So let me check something else. Like, let's just be a grade A dick about all this. Whoops. View offers. All right, now they're at 1 year, 2.6. I want 5. Wow. This is a dick move. But what if arbitration gives it to me? The Yankees are losing interest in negotiating with you. You have to be willing to sacrifice a little to make this a reality. Okay, but that's my offer. So, where are we at, gentlemen? I offered 5. Okay. Thought it was somewhere down the stretch here. Because if February is the day, my figure's got 2.3 is what I made. I want to get 5. You submit it to the panel. February's when it's due. Like, I don't really want to do this. I just want to see if they'll actually take it. You won your arbitration case. Wow. So arbitration is just basically money, which I don't really care, tell you the truth. This is interesting. I don't want that. I'll try to be realistic with it, so let's reload again. I want the 1 year deal, though, just because I don't want to stay here for like 10 years, you know? Part of my reasoning for this is because I don't want to take so much fucking money away from the Yankees that they can't give it to, like, you know, batters and good pitchers. Like, I don't want Chase Headley around and Trumbo. I don't want these guys sitting here for 6 fucking years because they stink. I'd rather have better batters. View offers. All right, they are offering a 1 year, 2.7. And that's fine. If my previous was, like, 2.3... I'll take 3. Just a flat 3, and let's call it that. The Yankees have refused your offer? You snaky fucking cunts. That's just garbage. Dude, I'm only asking 3 mil. Arbitration at one point gave me 5. So be thankful that I want just the fucking 3 million. You want to give me 2.3? That was last year. Dude, I'm asking 3, and that's it. I don't think that's too outrageous. Okay, it's been submitted. You won your arbitration case at $3 million. Okay, I'm staying as a New York Yankee, depending on how this team looks. The offseason has come to an end. Spring training is about to begin. Well, sim through this first day. There you have it. We are about to approach Season 4 spring training. I can't even look at the schedule there. Training and perks. Nothing on the low end. And we have about 4,000 points to work with, which is nice. Boy, you know, I want to get all my control up to fucking 90, excuse me. But that's going to cost a lot of fucking points. That's like 10,000 points per. Whew! That's going to be tough. It's going to be very tough. But I think having good control is something that I just need over time. Plus, I still need my fifth pitch. I need to get my fucking, I need to get my sinker to work in here. Wow. And I can't bat for shit. No numbers there. Fielding's not great, especially, you know, if I have to go and cover first base really quick. Can't run there in time. Baby Jesus, this is too much. But I'll worry about that shit later on, I suppose, because we are entering spring training the next time we play the live stream Let's Play of MLB The Show 16 right here. Well, it's only on the PS4. So, World Series champion. I didn't win Rookie of the Year, but I've won the Cy Young, I've won the MVP, I've won the pennant, and I've won the World Series. What else can I do? Well, I gotta wait out this time. I gotta wait out these arbitration years. And test free agency. Go to other teams. You know, kind of go where I want to go. You saw how I was doing my arbitration contract bullshit? That's kind of how I would do the free agency as well. Kind of see who the good teams are moving forward. I don't know if that's, Oh, yeah, we kind of can. Yeah, look at the team and look at the rating. Rank 9, rank 25, rank 19, rank 13. Now, if I had my way, notice I did say from the start of this entire run here when I created Derek Metzger, I want to go to the National League. So I'm forced to take swings and, you know, maybe win a Silver Slugger as a pitcher. That would be fucking cool as hell. But the Pirates, okay, I just beat them. Let's just say that my free agency came up. Well, before I get into spring training, you have to sign with a team, obviously. But the Pirates are a top 10 team. That's not bad. Wouldn't mind that. The Mets, 6 with pitching and power. Interesting. That wouldn't hurt me. The Astros. Boy, I have history with them. The first game I got called up when I was still in Baltimore, I played the Astros. Wouldn't that be interesting? Good power, good defense. I would help raise that pitching, I would hope, and good speed. Not bad. The Astros would be fun. The Twins are just missing out at 11th. Shit, me, the Yankees, fucking ranked 2nd, really? Wow. I really don't see it, because our bats just don't do enough for me personally. The Red Sox are ranked 4th. Good contact, pretty good defense. I don't need speed so much. We don't really need a base-running team. Well, seeing that Grapefruit and Cactus League are all over the place, I can't really make my point here, because a lot of these teams are American League teams now that I think about it. But anyway, who else? The Giants, that'd be fine. Great contact. I would only help that pitching, and the defense looks good. Jesus Christ. Go to the Dodgers. Yeah, me and Kershaw. Could you imagine that shit? If it were to happen. I mean, I know arbitration's going to take time, and it'll be done, but go to the Cubs. You have great contact, great power, great defense, and I would help your pitching. Jesus. You see how I would go about this. And sure, would I reload time and time and time again? Sure, I would. Just to end up going to a team that I want to go to. Because, I mean, if the free agent market only throws at me, let's just say, you know, I get an offer from the Padres. Would I honestly do that? They're the worst team in all of baseball. No. And let me just try to stick with National League teams here. Would I go to the Rockies at 28th? No. And, yeah, the Brewers. Let's just say those are my three offers. The Brewers, the Dodgers, or the Brewers, the Padres, and the Rockies. I would reload and wait for better offers from, well, doesn't matter the offer. I'd probably get about a 3-4 year contract is what I would aim for. And then try to ride that out with that team and see what happens. You'd be switching teams pretty much every fucking, every, you know, contract that's up. Maybe request a trade, who knows, but, you know, I wouldn't want to be stuck on shit teams. Go to the Phillies, who would want that? Because they're just not looking too hot. I wouldn't want that. Teams that are stuck in the 20s, if they're the only ones that give me offers, the Braves? Nope. Tigers aren't in it. You know what I'm saying, though. I can't even see all the Reds. Get my little face bubbles in the way. I can't quite see the name there, but you get the idea of how I would run that. But for now, with arbitration, hey, I went from $2.3 million last year to $3 million this year. I don't think that's eaten away too much into the fucking pockets of these fucking New York Yankees. You got the money. Don't fool me any. Viewing the roster, though, let me check the 40-man. Metzger, who is this? A relief pitcher. Dellin Betances. Chapman. Andrew Miller. Perez, 28 years old. Severino. Abreu. Mariznick is still here. Scope. God damn it. How long is he locked in? Can I check his contract? He has 1 year remaining. That makes me feel good. I can't even see all these names. Segura is a shortstop, 29 years old. Whew, he's got a couple years left. 84 overall is not bad. Giles. Ken Giles, where was he from? Okay, Philly and Houston, alright. He's got, well, just this year. And he plays... Can't even see. He's a closer? What? So why the fuck... We have Chapman already. Wow. Hector Rondon is another closer. Why do we have three closers on the 40-man roster? Fine if they're in the bullpen. Gary Sanchez, a 26-year-old catcher, 82 overall. That's not bad. He can build on that. Hasn't really done much, but he's got 5 years on his contract. Wow. Gerardo Parra, left fielder, 80 overall. Okay, here's where we start getting into the garbage. Eovaldi, Mueller. Okay, you're 22 years old. Starting pitcher, 79 overall. You can still build upon that. Is that what? Manny? Buenelos? I don't even know if I'm saying that right. In the last year of his deal. And we've had him. I just don't know the name. Fucking Hicks, the World Series MVP. The Phenom. This is his last year. Stefan Cortez. Starting pitcher. Ref Snyder. Why don't we get him in here a little more? No, Rob Ref Snyder is a real person. He's not a computer-generated guy. Ref Snyder sounds German as fuck, and he is... He's born from South Korea. That's really weird. Matt Moore, who I think was a Tampa Ray for the longest time. Yup. Got him on a 2-year deal. He is 75 overall, 29 years old. That's not good. Chen, 33 years old, 75. Nick Ahmed, you're 29 years old, 75, oh boy. Mendoza, Paredes, Valencia, Godley, Hickey, Mitchell, Brett Gardner, you're really getting old, kid. 35 and 73 overall, oof. Final year of his contract. F. Rodriguez, Fernando, is a relief pitcher, Corey Carew. Chase fucking Headley, 34 years old, 72 overall. He's garbage. This is the last year of his deal. Just trade his ass. We don't need him. I mean, look, where was his best year? Right here, 2012. Okay, 31 home runs, 150 RBI. He was traded 2 years after that to the Yankees and hasn't hit 20 home runs since. He's only hit 30 home... he's only hit 20 or more home runs once. And he's a career 260 hitter, which wouldn't be bad if he had power numbers behind it. But he fucking doesn't. Oh, I'm not a fan of his. I'm just not a fan of his. Shreve, Wooten, another Valencia? Huh. Romano Carmi, Wrecker, Pacheco. So, okay. On the plus side, we have a lot of guys 80 overall and better. A lot of them are closing pitchers for whatever reason, but that's kind of how the lineup's looking for spring training. So, Oh boy, let's look at a champion here, shall we? As I'm about to close out, well, I gotta say, World Series champion in my third year. At the end of my third year. Damn, just... Where do we go from here? Well, who knows, once arbitration is done, and we're able to test the free agent market. I mean, if this is my fourth year, four, five, six, we've played 3 years, we got three more years to go of arbitration years, possibly locked in with the Yankees. If this team goes to shit, and let me just look at that. We are allegedly the number two ranked team in all of baseball. So, just looking at that, I will check that number once spring training is done. But, that's just where we're at right now. Sorry, mic bump there as I looked over. Well, it looks good for now. If we're the number two ranked team in all of baseball behind, I think it was the Cubs, who really look good. Boy, if I went there, contact, power, defense, pretty much maxed out. Pitching, I would help. Nothing against the Yankees here, but, well, we don't have the contact, we don't have the power, speed looks the same, defense is good. Pitching is better, mainly because of me, let's not lie. I would rather be on a team that's got, like, fair pitching that I can improve. And then power and contact. Plus, that's the National League, which is what I'm aiming for. I will say that, well, if I can make the disclaimer now, hopefully I remember when it happens, but when free agency hits in another three fucking years, we've already done 3 years of this fucking road to the show career of Derek Metzger. Yeah, I want to go to a top 10 team, rank-wise, in the National League, so I'm forced to take swings. Something a little extra for you to watch. Just, you know, humor. Watch me fuck up batting. Swing at garbage. Fuck up on the base paths and get caught stealing. Who knows? That's more for the amusement factor. But also, help my cause with insurance runs. Who knows? That's kind of the next big step that I want to do, is go to a good National League team and take some swings. A Silver Slugger award would be great. That might be the next little award, the next step that I can logically take. But that's, like I said, that might be three more years. What more can we do with Derek Metzger? Well, spring training due up as we start year four of this career. So, for those of you that checked here live on Twitch, or you watch episodically at your own leisure on YouTube, thanks so much for checking everything out. But we're rolling out for now as a World Series champion. Hey, you wear the pinstripes, good things happen, I guess. Better than Baltimore, but maybe we end up there. Who knows? We're just going to have to see as we will next time start season year four on MLB The Show 16, which will actually be... what'll this be? The start of the 2019 season. I had to look, yeah. I can't just think 16, 17, 18, 19. Can't even count it out in my brain. It's just how I am, whatever. But MJ signing out for now. And as usual, everybody, till we meet again. And as usual, I'll catch your ass down the road. The road to the show.